Well, Aussies are staring down the barrel of another rate rise today as the Reserve Bank tries to curb surging inflation. But what impact will the hike have on the property market?
That's the question. Let's bring in Domain's Alice Stoles in Melbourne. Alice, how should we prepare for the inevitable cash rate rise today?
Good morning, guys. Yes, the first Tuesday of the month for many Australians is beginning to feel like a reoccurring bad dream, isn't it? With the RBA set to meet today with an expectation there'll be a further rate rise. And this is obviously going to be affecting first-time buyers, existing borrowers, as well as investors. The full spectrum of the market is impacted here. In terms of what people can do to prepare for it, you really need to be baking these rate rises into your financial planning and budget. On the screen here, find the price bracket of what you're borrowing and what you are currently borrowing, and understand this is going to be here to stay for a while longer. Also, if you have got pre-approval, I'll be checking with your lender or bank to ensure that is still in existence for the months ahead with these rate rises, because obviously pre-approval when it was set a few months ago can actually change given the climate that we're in at the moment.
It's so interesting. Anecdotally, I've got several friends who have small businesses and they reckon the cash has dried up. They reckon that people just aren't spending. Yet that's not going to address inflation in any way, shape or form. We were talking about this morning vegetables going up, these floods in New South Wales causing veggies to go up for months on end.
Yeah.
So it's two-tiered in many ways. How are these rate rises going to impact on the rental market, do you think?
Carl, you're completely right. And the renter market is also under severe pressure at the moment. Vacancy rates came out yesterday and they are the lowest in our history. You can see that Sydney at the moment is down to 1.4, Adelaide's down to 0.3. The only silver lining I have to say here is most of these have stabilised. So with the idea being if they stabilised for the past 4 months, it may have reached its bottom in terms of the vacancy rates. But it is a tough time in the rental market and a tough time in the buying market. So refinance, see what you can do to save money because we've got to batten down the hatches.
What does this all mean though for first home buyers? I mean, for so long they've been priced out of the market. Now that interest rates are up, everyone's a bit more cautious. Does this help them in any way?
Look, for first home buyers, the good news is that prices will soften. The bad news is they're not going to be able to borrow as much, which, well, perhaps one could argue isn't such a bad thing after all. On Friday, the government's home guarantee scheme starts and buyers are going to be able to buy for as little as a 5% deposit. Look, so there are some bright spots for first home buyers, and I think with competition out of the market, it's going to be less pressure on them. So they've got to find their way in, but they've got to do it with caution and understanding that rates will continue to rise in the preceding months.
Starting to all work. I mean, 25,000 people refinancing just in the last little bit, so it's starting to bite. Good on you. Thank you so much, Alice.
Thanks, Alice.
So Aussies refinancing their homes has hit a record high with new data from the ABS revealing nearly 25,000 Australians ditched their bank for another provider in May alone. So this comes as interest rates are tipped for a third rise in as many months when the board of the Reserve Bank meets in a matter of hours.
Today, money expert Effie Zahos is here to discuss. Effie, good morning.
Good morning.
First off, we know there's going to be a rise today. Yep. How high will it be?
Well, first off, those numbers are great that people are moving. Year on year, 23% jump from comparing last year's figures, people refinancing externally. How much are they going to move today? Well, how aggressive is the RBA going to be? 0.5 is what I put down, but there is talk of 0.75. Maybe they'll follow what the Fed did. But because the Fed meets less often, I'm putting my money on 0.5. What that means is that with the last three rate hikes, including today, your mortgage repayments on a $500,000 loan will be up $351.
Okay. Why wouldn't they just go higher and stop doing it every month? Why not just jump to
set it?
Yeah,
set and forget.
That makes sense initially, and probably they should have done it earlier. But looking at even data now, spending data that's coming out from like CBA, NAB, and ANZ, we're actually pulling back.
We are, yeah.
Yeah, so I feel that they may, you know, go hard and fast 0.5. Wouldn't surprise me if we went 0.75 and then hold back and see. But you know, we'll meet again. The RBA will meet again.
The problem is that part of the economy is not changing. Inflation insofar as the costs we're paying for goods.
Yeah.
And that's not going to end anytime soon because of the supply issues.
And this is the hard thing with the RBA because it's not just demand-driven, this inflation. Yeah. It is supply. So you can't really gauge that. So it is a case of throwing out, pulling back, how far it's going to go, test the economy. But they you know, the 0.5 is probably a no-brainer, but I'm hearing talks of 0.75. Yeah, interesting.
Not everyone loves to haggle, but you're advising it in this instance.
I certainly am. If you haven't been one of those thousands that have done it already, now is the time to do it. There are a couple of steps in here, and I'll put a little formula together if you can formalise this. First of all, what you need to do is find out, what am I paying right now? The RBA's told us that new customers get better deals, in fact, in April by 0.45. That number there is what the average variable rate is, according to CanStar now, because rates are moving. So that's what the average is. Did you know banks actually have dirt cheap rates? Like 2.9 is the average from the major banks. Now, a lot of major banks have already reduced their variable rates, but it's for new customers only. Right. That was the cheapest in the market. So your question is, can I get that right?
Yeah. You wanted to role play this morning?
I did, but I do want to just check. To get these good rates, you have to tick one of these boxes.
Okay.
I love to role play, Carl. and Sarah.
Okay, so it's never gotten so interesting.
If you can tick, let's stick to the script here, guys. If you can tick one of these boxes, at least three. So you live in the house, you're paying principal and interest.
Yeah.
You're a good customer. You've got lots of equity.
Yeah.
You work for someone, because it's always easier if you're an employer, you've been there for a while. If you can tick several of these boxes, you are in the driver's seat. So let's role play.
Mm.
Okay, so I'm calling you. Ring, ring.
Hi.
Hello, Carl, Sarah.
Yeah. I'll let Carl handle this one.
Having two bankers is a very unusual situation.
Right.
Just one. Look, Carl, I've been checking my mortgage rates and how they compare with what you're giving new customers, and I'm really disappointed that mine is much higher than that. And then I'll decide off what I'm good at. I've got a great credit score. I have a big loan. I've never missed a repayment. Surely you can do something better for me.
Surely you can do something better for me.
Yes, for me.
Yeah.
What are you going to do for it, Carl?
Yeah, I can do that, and maybe knock it down by 0.5%.
0.5%?
And take it longer.
That was quick.
Over 40 years.
That was so quick.
Is it always that easy, Effie?
That was an anticlimax. I'd like to get more, actually, because the cheapest rate out there. I'm going to pack it there, but that is online, I believe.
We should never role play.
There's a great script there that you can use if you tick off those boxes. And I think you've just got to do
that now. All right, Effie, that's enough.